up, we're down here at MSC Drift Track. So it's been my first competition for a while. Last time went out in competition was last year at Summer Bash, which was like pretty much a year ago. So I'm feeling pretty good, done a lot of practice on the simulator of this track, and yeah, it should be a lot of fun. There's a lot of competitors here, so should be some good competition.
It'll still be that normal line too, we'll go wide. Right after that rumble. Really quick him punch this wall, eh? Yeah, so you probably get off and make this a real
shit. That's gonna get fast. Linc, you better hang on, mate.
We just have Darren here, so if something goes wrong, we blame Darren, is it?
Well, that was what was happening in bloody Australia.
I think all the Kiwis like, oh, Darren!
So, bro, I ain't even got a car here.
Just this side had a bit more camber than the that side, like by a degree or so. You're probably not too far off, but yeah. 1.6 on the ground.
So that's a full droop, and then
and then on the other side it's like 3.
That's a lot of droop. It doesn't actually change much.
No,
it should change only a degree in that hole.
Yeah.
See what he reckons, and then I mean, then we could even zero it out.
Yeah.
Because you've got a lot of adjustment at the top.
The only thing to run into this. So.
Fenders will last 2 laps of this pit driving.
It's all art, mate.
See? It's all art, mate. Crash, you just make it art.
That's why the spares kit today, we've just got Posca pens, so we just keep adding scratches.
Yeah, where's the scratches?
It's
where's
meant
the
to be like that. That's how we roll.
Can you go to the bottom of the actual...
A few of the Drift Force residents here. Should be good fun. Link's usually up in control tower watching these guys. Now he's getting to battle with them.
Stickers! We love stickers!
Look at the size of
it! The heat gun, mate! Look at that!
Big bubbles, no troubles.
Yeah, mate. It's what you do is it keeps it lightweight.
Secret, mate.
2 seconds.
Yeah, because then second is way more responsive, so it just gives you that frickin' if you need to pounce.
Punching off.
A professional, and look at my frickin', I got a gold card.
And a frickin', what are we, yeah, mate, we're frickin'.
Is he calling you a professional because you're holding that knife?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah,
he's scared. He's running to the other side of the pit.
Good call.
Oh shit, he's got to get a new license.
Yeah, so only, look, he only got this last year before summer back.
Yeah, so we've Linc been racing since 6 years old to have gone through the process of always, even at 6, had to get dispensation. Because the age was 7 years to race the little trophy carts, Kiwi trucks. But there's actually quite a few youngsters here. This championship would be good because there's quite a few teenagers. It's the cool thing about drifting. It's such an accessible sport. It's honestly cheaper to do than go-kart racing on the tarmac because you can come down here. Sky's always doing his school days. He's doing open track days, similar to how we do our Drift Force. And so I literally just rock up with something that's rear-wheel drive, bring some spare tires down and have a go. And if you've got stuff that's low power, then you know, guys will bring, well, Kieran Stewart, he comes down with a set of tires, he's got an MX5 the same as Linc, but just with a stock like 4-cylinder in, and he drifts all day on the same set of tires and then drives home, swaps his wheels over. But then also it can be freaking expensive as well.
Following the...
This is a world-class pit crew if I've ever seen, my name.
Oh, yeah.
It's an F1 pit stop, yeah.
Now that he's got long legs, I can actually fit in his cars, look.
What?
Maybe not. My head's out the top.
Fire in the hole.
Saying this inner clip number 3, don't have to focus so much on a massive angle. Come through there and then just make that a nice snappy flip, flick there. and then you'll find yourself wide, full throttle all the way to that finish. Drives the wheel, so it actually tows the wheels in. It's nowhere near as much movement, but I reckon that, because you see, if you come in, when you're off the gas, it's almost like the wheels want to tow out.
Yeah.
And then as soon as you're on the gas, it just freaking drives you. Like, I don't know. I keep thinking you're going to go off on that.
Yeah, like, come in here, and it feels like I'm going to go straight, then I get off the gas, and just go straight.
Yeah. How you feeling?
Yeah, so just done a couple laps of practice now, feeling pretty good. Took me a while to get used to different pressures. We changed tire pressures up from last time, so spun out, I think, once or twice. But yeah, getting pretty used to it now, feeling good. I keep thinking I'm gonna go into the bank in this zone, but then it's got so much forward drive that I just get on the gas and it just goes straight forward. But yeah, feeling good.
Fluidity, if they're not like fluid.
I just don't even like the word fluidity. Like, fluidity to me just sounds like it's going to put someone asleep. Just be dangerous and dynamic and to try execute that, you're doing exactly that. Like, I just mean the revs, the gear, the upshifts.
It's not like fluid, but it still looks good, then they shouldn't mark them down for that. Like,
yeah.
And then also, if they're going outside the zone and they're closer to a wall, that should be marked up for them.
Yeah. Bonus trigger.
Oh, yep.
Yeah,
do you have any thoughts? What are we
doing? Good. Yeah. Some real good clean laps on that last session. It's really a track where you've got to get your balance of gear ratio, just like picking your gears, getting the wheel speed right, and then
yeah, just nailing the line. You got to make sacrifices on that back corner of where you go wide and where you like slightly cut in and then get back out wide. So like it's impossible to stay wide the whole way around. So that last session he got that perfect, came around. It makes the whole front section here that much better. And yeah, the last corner was really the only spot he was semi-struggling at initially, but nailed it for four or five laps in a row. So looking good. Good first couple of sessions.
Definitely the fastest, that's for sure. Yeah, that's what I was wanting to chasing. So yeah. Save some of these tires.
Really not too like I'm the fastest watching.
Way faster,
you
just want to be a little bit faster than the fastest car, mate.
Yeah, if you're way faster, then you're like, random states where it becomes more of a difficult mean leading, and then when you go to chase, mate, it's impossible.
Now it's just, it's more that angle, the line, and then the style. Which style, you got 40 points, it's the most. So.
Going on, that better?
I don't know if it was the first tag Linc come in and just tagged that wall, and I don't know if that was enough to then break that bolt, because then I thought it looked like he just was out of control. That fix is pretty easy, it's just a UJ with the bolt that snapped the bolt, and on the front right looks like a wheel bearing. So, but we've brought minimal spares. We've got the spares we need, I think, and worst case the shop is right there.
Yep, so I'm all good after the little up the bank try to do some off-roading, but actually my chase runs actually felt really good. I felt really confident with my chase runs, which I mean I was actually quite surprised with, because I've like never done chase runs before. The one time I did at Summer Bash, I like cooked up the start and then yeah, couldn't manage to catch back up, but clicked third, came around the sweeper. And then I just flicked it into here. Everything felt the same as what I usually did. I think don't know if I came in a bit faster or something, but then as soon as like one back wheel just hit the dirt on the outside, it felt like it just kept sliding back out, like I had no grip. So it just kept sliding out, and then, yeah, so I just went up the bank, and then steering felt, well, obviously it's, they're sorting that out now. I'm all good, just, yeah, quite bummed out, but yeah, should be able to get the problem fixed.
Are these factory ones?
Oh, that's just factory, yeah. Like Repco, oh. Worst case, we can go fucking Repco and get
four. Yeah. I see how it is. Hiding in his pocket.
Well, I'm a bit worried about how many are melting.
It'll be a smoothie by now.
Yeah.
No, I just got them, but not delivered.
They're like what they would not expect, and we're gonna like hit some of them. I'm like, yeah, fine, we'll jump this one.
Yeah.
Like, in the truck. I'm like, yeah, it's like pouring of rain. Oh, credit to
like
bloody.
Crossed up one.
Yeah, flick it off the top edge.
Oh, shit.
No, like, as long as the jumps aren't like this time.
Oh, yeah. Fucking lead foot.
Oh yeah, this guy. So we're at the start line, and there's Cole and him. He's like, oh bro, like,
hit the big jump.
Yeah, you should hit the bike ramp and now the jump. I'm like, oh yeah. Give it a go, I just hit a tap. Fucking landed on my side and then just wrench the truck. Boom, up onto the hay bales.
That's right.
And then you hear Tony's video. Like,
what an idiot.
Yeah, Linc's like six, like, what was he thinking?
Like, what an idiot.
Not like, oh, dad, shit, are you alright? Fuck. It's just like, what an idiot.
That's some Dukes of Hazzard shit.
That is, that is not my dad. Well, because then you were doing the demos in the bloody...
Yeah.
So Rod's like, oh yeah, let's get Linc down. He can be the youngest, bloody youngest person to ever do lead foot. We'll give you this paddock. And then we made that little track for you, eh?
Oh, yeah,
and then he's
right.
Like, brr.
And then you could just see he was just super frustrated. Then next minute he just made his own track.
Off the berms and round. Then Rod comes down. He's like, fuck, that's cool, but shit. He's like, that's really cool. Look up there. He's like, you've literally dusted out the whole VIP suite. He's like, it's great because everyone's come out drinking champagne and crackers.
Come to watch.
Come to watch. But he's like, yeah, they're all just dirt in their teeth. And
that's what it's all about.
They're like,
make it look like it wasn't meant to.
Yeah.
Where's he going?
Yeah. I'm like 30 seconds off his time and I'm like at the start line to the microphone. Dude, come here, bro. Tell the whole crowd, mate, I'm beating Rod's time up this hill. People are like, mate, you're dreaming. And then, bang, bang, bang.
Yeah.
Tyler West will be probably looking to play it pretty safe here. Moses has a horsepower speed advantage.
Yeah, so I think today went really well. Sort of like my second competition, did Summer Bash about a year ago. Yeah, so the morning qualifying had a sort of all right run, had like a 60, 61 or something, I think was my score. I think I just had the mindset of just get a score on the board. Yeah, I didn't really want to have that mindset, but it ended up being that way. So then my second qualifying run went out, just sent it, ended up getting like 72.5 or something like that. So that put me way higher on the board. got like another 10 points added, qualified like 12th, so I was actually really happy with that. And then, yeah, my first battle went up against Curtis Lilly. I actually really enjoyed that battle as well. It was sort of hard to match the speed of chasing, but I think I ended up getting it pretty well. And then my lead run, I couldn't see Curtis behind me, but I could see everyone's cheering in the pits when I go past out of the corner of my eye. So yeah, thinking that went pretty well. So in top 16, I was up against Isaac. I know he's a really consistent driver, so I started off with my chase. I was able to really get on his door. That was probably my best chase so far, and I was quite proud of that. And then, yeah, onto my lead run. I just came into the first corner. Felt like I had quite a lot of angle throughout the day going into there. I actually had a feeling I was gonna spin a couple of times in practice this morning. And actually in practice this morning, I spun on that corner in front of him. So then it happened again in my lead run. So I was pretty bummed that I got knocked out by just a silly mistake, but yeah, I'm really looking forward to the next one.